Soil clay particles can be unattached to one another, dispersed, or clumped together, flocculated, in aggregates. Soil aggregates are cemented clusters of sand, silt, and clay particles. Flocculation is desirable because water moves mostly through large pores between aggregates. Also, plant roots grow mainly between aggregates. Clay particles are negatively charged, anions, and when bonded with divalent cations, such as calcium or magnesium, can make soil particles stick together or flocculate. Calcium and magnesium are good flocculators, while sodium is a poor flocculator, or can actually disperse the clay in soil. The ratio of bad to good flocculators is expressed as the sodium adsorption ratio, or SAR. SAR is the balance between calcium and magnesium ions and sodium ions, Na+. Another important consideration is the total quantity of dissolved ions in a soil. Dissolved ions conduct electricity, so the total amount of soluble soil ions can be estimated by measuring the electrical conductivity, EC, of a soil water extract. Soil with a high EC is salty. Soil with a low EC is not. Stability of the soil structure, especially in a fine textured or clayey soil, depends on the SAR, the board in the seesaw, and the amount of soluble salts in the soil, EC, the fulcrum of the seesaw. If the soil contains sufficient calcium and magnesium, the seesaw tips towards Ca2+ and Mg2+, and soil particles will flocculate. If the soil contains high levels of sodium, it tips toward Na+, and soil particles will disperse. Here you would have flocculated soil, lower SAR. Here you would have dispersed soil, higher SAR. If EC is increased, soil particles will flocculate even if the soil has a lot of sodium. If EC is decreased, soil particles may disperse.